Hello, my name is Andy Schlosser, and I am an engineer with ChassisSim Technologies. Today we're going to go over a new tool in order to assist the use of Pi Toolbox with ChassisSim, as well as some other tips and tricks in order to be able to better integrate ChassisSim and Pi Toolbox. So the Monster Maker import tool allows us to simplify the backbone of ChassisSim and allows us to integrate into Pi Toolbox a little bit easier. So in addition to this, we're going to go over some of the tips and tricks that help us import the Pi ASCII files the ChassisSim exports into Pi Toolbox. For reference, in this demo, we're going to be using Pi Toolbox 11, and the data logged is logged on a CLU. Now, as far as what we actually have to export in order to use the Monster Maker, it's the same set of channels that it's normally and typically used in order to build a monster file with what you have on your car. For example, if you don't have airspeed or a Z-axis accelerometer, or load cells, you don't actually need to worry about that for the import. Something that allows us to use additional features of the Monster Maker are lap time, lap number, and altitude. To show you what the Monster Maker actually looks like, it's this little guy here. So you get a drop-down menu with the channel picker in order to pick each of the files, as well as some utilities that we'll go through more in a little bit. So the actual first step in creating a monster file out of the Monster Maker is to generate your Pi ASCII file. So I have an example workbook that has nothing really to script in it for the example, but you want to right-click your file in the task, hit Export Outing, and then when you go through the steps, you first want to make sure you're exporting to somewhere that you know where it is, which we are in this case. I'm going to demo the use of the lap selection function in the Monster Maker, so I'm going to select entire outing. If you only want to do one lap, don't worry about it. You can do time span and select it just as you would have before. So from within here, the same settings that we always export, speed, loads, damper position, etc., etc. And then don't forget to do lap time as well as lap number. Don't need lap distance. So just to go over the channels, just as we had discussed before, we have speed, engine speed, and airspeed, three axes of accelerometers, damper travel and pushrod load, steered angle and throttle pedal position, lap time, lap number, and altitude. So after selecting these channels, make sure that they're exported at 50 hertz. Don't worry about any events, and then let it go. Cool. So now we've generated the Pi ASCII file, and we can use that within the Monster Maker import file. Now that we've actually exported the Pi ASCII file, we can create it using the Monster Maker tool. So the first step is to select the file that we just exported, which is right here. And now all these drop-down menus are populated. So we can go through and we can make sure that everything is where it's supposed to be. We have all the correct channels selected, which makes life a lot easier. So this car was fortunate enough to be fitted with all of the necessary sensors to create a full and complete monster file. So we're going to show those off and use the full functionality of the monster file generator. Now, you don't obviously need every sensor on the car to do this, but we may as well show off all the features that we can. If you would like to use any of the optional channels, then you go in here and you click the box next to it before selecting your channel itself. Now, in addition to the standard set of complements, if you check use altitude, it'll create a second altitude file for you that you can use in altitude camber generation. And that'll be the one of the first things that we show off because the standard GPS altitude file is a little bit notchy. So we're actually going to use this filtering tool and go in and filter it. So the filter works over the same style as a moving average filter used in Pi Toolbox. So you enter the time that you would like to filter moving average in the channel, and you click filter. And now a new channel shows up at the bottom, which is the channel name, plus the time, plus filt. Since we also had lap number and lap distance in there, we can actually pick a lap that we would like to use. So for example, in this case, we'll use lap 165 rather arbitrarily. Now we select an output file. And if we go back into the same folder, I'll title it Monster Maker Output for simplicity. We'll see that we get a file path here. So then you click the button underneath and it tells you that it was created and it gives you the lap time that it was created at. Another utility that's baked in here is you can check your units. So if you check your units and nothing comes up, that means that everything is in the correct unit. Now, if I'm going to go through and put in a channel that is not obviously in the correct unit, for example, a pushrod load, I will switch to damper travel. Now we check units and we can see that it's set in millimeters and not kilogram force. This allows us to go through and generally make sure that we have things correct before we actually go through and make sure and actually go through the process of generating the monster file. And the last feature that's baked in here is zeroing channels. So if we pull up the zeroing control, which is a long full graph that starts out with speed, you can bring up other channels in the display, such as your dampers or your loads. Now, the asterisk here is that the plotting library that is built into this tool is not very robust at the moment, so sometimes it does produce errors. In order to actually go through the process of zeroing something, you click and drag onto the area. So if you're trundling down the pit lane, the normal area of a zero, you've got this nice flat spot there, and click once right there, and then select the channels you'd like to zero. For example, you could zero your pushrod loads and your damper travel here, your steer wheel angle. We pull it up. We can see the steer wheel angle doesn't really come up all the way. We're working on that. In order to finish this, hit select, and now it'll actually zero whenever you generate the monster file at this point. Another feature that is built in is that if you already have exported a monster file out of the tool using this file and using this tool, with the same logger name, you can actually have the settings latch. So if we open up a new instance of the Monster Maker and bring up another file that has the same name, we can see that the channel names automatically repopulate. This is great. It allows for us to effectively go through and create a whole bunch of different monster files at one time out of different lap files. It just really streamlines the process and makes it all a tremendous amount easier. Now, the other half of using Pi Toolbox with ChassisSim is to actually go through and be able to import the files back in again. So the ASCII importing does have some hurdles within Pi Toolbox, and a lot of that derives out of the global unit settings. We have to make sure that the channel names match what we're expecting to import, and we also have to make sure that the units match. After the file is actually imported, it can be treated like any other Pi unit. To give you an example of this process, I first have this workbook that has a ChassisSim generated file that is set to miles per hour. The car is the LMP2 Plus car from the current ChassisSim competition and is going around Phillip Island, I believe I have it set at, which is a track that I just think is particularly cool. So the files are currently at miles per hour. Now, if I'm going to go in and if I'm going to go add in this file from the same simulation, it's the exact same simulation, it just is in kilometers per hour, we can see that it doesn't actually import correctly, and I truly doubt that this car is going 308 miles per hour. So in order to make this tool import properly, what we have to do is first make sure that those are taken out, and second, we go into our global channel properties, which is up here, and we'll go into speed, and make sure that speed is set to kilometers per hour. Now when we add the outing back in, and we are using the same exact file, we can see that it overlays exactly once more. See, it's both files there. So the real trick here is to make sure that the units are set the same whenever you're going into Pi Toolbox in the global channel settings. This applies to the ASCII imports primarily, and it is a hurdle that we have to watch for, and it is a problem if your workbook is not in SI. There are some features within ChassisSim that allow you to export the Pi Toolbox distance in Imperial. However, really at this stage in the game, most likely the easiest solution is to export your run into Pi Toolbox from ChassisSim. And if your units are incompatible, then just very briefly switch them and then switch them right back. Everything will be fine after that. As we can see, I go into the global channel properties again. I can set it to miles per hour and everything is just fine. It still overlays. It's only in that initial import. So if any files are off of the typical settings that you use, that is the solution in order to make them back and be correct again. This tool and those tips and tricks help overcome the main hurdles in integrating Pi Toolbox and ChassisSim. Hopefully these are helpful for other people involved, and I look forward to talking to everybody again soon.